But before we proceed this evening, we must acknowledge the Almighty Creator Himself, Chukwukika Abiyama, the one who remains the primordial influence that drives us in everything we do. Anyi na jage mau nihi na emaramai ihunanya ni nagi ubiomagi ujuru anyanya dadio ingwe gimbangwe odigonye dikagi ibu wafanu mega anyi nini nasina Once again, fellow Biafrans, I welcome you to this segment, A Moment of Inspiration and Grit. Still in the mood of the 30th of May, the time, the period, we remember our fallen heroes and heroines. Both dead and alive, we remember them. We will never forget their sacrifice. It will never be in vain. Very close to the deal day. 30th of May. But then, the truth cannot be overemphasized. We must all work very hard to find out the reason why these men and women, against all odds, were willing to lay down their life. For today, they know fully well that they may not see. And then our national anthem said, if the price for all we hold dear is death, then let us die without a shred of fear. And now you know where they are coming from. Without wasting much of our time, our topic this evening is simple. They died to stop a nation built on falsehood, a nation built on lies. And sometimes you begin to wonder, why are they willing to give up anything? They did not die for Oye Well. They didn't die for the coal in Enugu. They did not die for human resources or any other grammar you were speaking. We didn't have media, and it was easy for you to lie against our ancestors, saying that Ojukwu is fighting for Biafra to secede from Nigeria because he wants Oye. But now, lo and behold, we do not control any oil. We do not control the gold nor the diamond in Biafra, in the zoo called Nigeria. We're absolutely not even in control of our life. Yet we want to go. So what lie are you going to peddle any longer? Do you still have any version? You have not unleashed. You have not implemented. You have not initiated against us as a people. And now you know. And now you know the truth is coming. And Nigeria is sinking because we will pull Nigeria down. Not with AK-47. But with the truth, the naked truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Generation of 1967 to 1970, among all that who died in different dispensation, they died to make sure they stop a country built on lie, a country built on falsehood. There is no miserable people like that on the face of the planet Earth. But how can you understand? Today, there is no more hope. As we speak today, there is more hope for a fool in Nigeria than normal human being. The fools in Nigeria have more hope than the intellectuals. There is more hope for a fool than for those who claim to be one Nigeria. Because the fool has no full understanding of what they do. But the Nigerians are supposedly a country of wise people who live in pretense. Majority of Nigerians make their wealth in deception and in a crude way on the expense of their people. There is more hope for a fool than the person that claims to be a Nigerian. Why? Because majority of Nigerians claim to be wise. They claim to be very wise. And so they live their life on falsehood. on the expense of their people, they amass wealth. And when we see them, when we watch them, when we observe them, we could see clearly why our fathers died. And then this country of lies, this evil enclave called Nigeria, this Satan abode, Lord Lugard creation. Look at where it is today. They keep lying to you. Kaduna governor creates youth and sports. But it's a lie. They can go on quoting one thing or the other. Buhari addressed the state of nation. It's a lie. I was looking at Jubri, and that Awosa fellow Fulani terrorist said to him, how do we describe you, oh President Buhari? Some people say you are a corruption fighter. Some people say you are a good man. Some people say you are intelligent. Some people say you are wonderful. You don't loot money. You gave proper account of ICPC, EFCC, IDPC, NNPC. Only Buhari. Only Jubri. And that man in pretense said to him, but sir, how can you define yourself? And Jubri went on to say, you see, I must first of all thank my fishers, because my fishers, they taught me to fight corruption. When I was in primary school, I was in boarding school. I was in boarding school. And when I was in secondary school, I was in boarding school. I was in boarding school. I must touch my teacher very well. And I say, wow. You mean Buhari went to school, or Jubri went to boarding school? Buhari, you went to boarding school, in primary school, in the zoo called Nigeria? No. This is a lie. Lie of the highest order. The same Buhari, which the whole lawyer son in Nigeria are defending his certificate, forged by WAEC, forged by the Nigerian government. He's telling you, you see, attack my teacher. Who is his teacher? And now you see the light. And why won't you stand up? You see, I started by saying that a fool have more hope than those who claim to be Nigerian. And then one has come to the media and said, no, Fulani herdsmen have been criticized so much. They need a radio to talk for themselves. Who is deceiving who? Who is deceiving who? But it's Joe Ibukwe. And now let me digress before I continue. Because as I'm speaking now, Oduduwa Nation have rallied round to support Obasanjo. And then don't you see how stupid you are as a Biafran telling us that Nnamdi Kanu does not have the capacity, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu does not have the capacity to deliver Biafrans from Nigeria. Look at Oduduwa. They are all rallying round. Otta Baboum gave a speech. A copyright speech by our leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. The next terrorist, the founder of cultists in Nigerian University, Woloshoinka supported him. The next thing, the Oduduwa Nation, all of them endorsed what that terrorist, that criminal Obasanjo did. International thief. Fela knew this truth. And now as I'm speaking to you, some people are claiming to be Urobu Shekiri Edas. They support what Obasanjo did. But let me tell you how it's going to end. All these people will do gra-gra. They will receive a lot. Before the end of this week, all of them will receive a lot. It is gone. There were some of them saying, no, Onaga cannot be removed. No, Edwin Clark House cannot be invaded. No, you can't remove our son in the EFCC or DCPC or CPCP or IKQQ. All of them have received alerts. Now they are moot. A nation built on falsehood. So when you are remembering the fallen heroes, those who are still alive, you should understand that one of the reasons they fought for, one of the reasons they want to stop the zoo called Nigeria is because it's a nation built on falsehood. Like I said, let's digress a little bit. All of a sudden, there are different group of people. Now, I am not making any mistake. Let me reintroduce myself. I am George Onyebe. I am from Abo. Abo is in Delta State. And Delta State is Biafra land. And I serve the indigenous people of Biafra, at least in this moment, as the African rep and the Nigerian international coordinator. As I talk now, I still did there. But it's a great privilege. It's an honor. And I hope one day, somebody who can do this better than me, God will present them. For what we want is our freedom for the avoidance of doubt. Now, without apology, listen to what I'm saying to you this evening. All of a sudden, everybody now is broadcasting. And some of you are very happy. Oh, we are doing it. We are going home. Oh, we are formidable. Oh, I want you to watch because there is more beneath the eyes can see. Take record of the names I want to mention now without apology. I won't talk about Iruanya. I won't talk about Umiumiu. I won't talk about this group of because these are known enemies who have shown themselves already. But I'm talking about those wolves in sheep clothing. How did it start? Am I going to talk about Asare? He have shown himself. All those people have packed their motto. But let me tell you the ones you are not seeing now. Somebody came. He starts saying, oh, he want to do Osu cast. Most of you gave him money. You are dashing him money. Today he's looking for 20 virgin and 30 virgin to deliver Biafra. Make on our open on our eyes. But I understand how our people behave. That is why Yoruba people are the one leading you to heaven. As knowledgeable as you are, as wise as you are, one Muslim Yoruba pastor will ask you to kneel down and he will pray for you. And you are very proud chimpanzee. No. Do you know how we look at you when we see you? As knowledgeable as you are, one Yoruba native doctor is the one leading you to heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now you see why fella say, waka, I go many places, Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Now you see, I think fella father, fella mother romanced a Biafra man. Fella is not a Yoruba man. I've never seen a formidable man like him. Very few. But let me not digress further. Let's focus. And now this man came. I think they call him Okechukwu. Many people have written to me and say, don't talk to him. Leave them. But am I talking to them? I want you to know how a nation built on falsehood, manifest, so that the next generation should get ready. For what we do on this platform will echo into eternity. The next generation of Biafran that will allow themselves to be bamboozled and stupidly used will have themselves to blame. Today we are not blaming our father because they did their best. Their best may not be good enough, but they did their best. If you don't understand it, consult me, inbox me. He said his name is Okechukwu. Osu cast. Hey, God is not angry. God is angry because we cast Osu. Okay, we are delivering Osu. You have done Osu cast. Where is Biafra? Facebook, you better cut me off very soon. Because the length I might go this night, you will not like it. Osu cast. Today now they are telling you now that don't eat pounded yam. It is too much carbohydrate. Is that what we are looking for? Now they are telling you we need 10 virgin. Best who has not been. Do you think there is any virgin on the face of this planet Earth? You see any 10 years old Nigerian man that is a virgin? Take that child to test. When our Hausa is sleeping with cow, Yoruba sleeping with goat, you are saying looking for virgin. Then we will never be delivered. Watch them. These people, I saw a broadcast online. And the sisters say they don't want to come to IPUB. They condemn Abeno Babe. They condemn Amadioha. They condemn Ekpetu. They condemn Akiemoho. They condemn all the deities in Biafra land because their hands are not clean. But when they are saying, it's against the will of God. Pastor marrying pastor, is it the will of God? But let's not go there anyway. That one pass. Many of you have supported them. You have given them money because it's your love for Biafra. But wake up. You see, that is why I said that a fool have more hope than any Nigerian-minded individual. That one is aside. And then you have one now. He's on Facebook. I say, we are Biafran BSS, Abi BQQ, Abi QQQ. We are going to defend our land. We are going to kill Nigeria. We are going to... He will know. You after smoking, he will say, sure, I understand the canoe. I love Amazon. And most of you are giving them money. It's on Facebook. You see, when you're not making sense, I don't even need to remember your name. And sometimes when I come on, I say, what is the name of this man? What's the name of... See, some people think I forget the name. I want to tell you that your name can never be remembered. We know your name. It is embedded in our DNA. It has been cloned. It has been placed, stamped in our head. We can't forget you because your sins will never be blotted out. Forever it will be remembered. We will never forget, neither we will forgive. Isn't that what Fulani tells you? We don't forgive. We are Fulani. We are terrorists. We don't forgive. We shall see. Another one came. That one say he's Blue Jack. No, let me finish with the defense. We need to defend our land. Give us money. They are calling you and you are giving them money. You are giving them money. Give us, we let's defend our land. We are terrible. We are guilty. We are formidable. But you are gullible. Now you imbox them and give them money. Ask them, tell them to look for the nearest IPOB family to join. A woman called in my money program and complained bitterly. I understand her plight. But I'm happy that woman have a coordinator. And the coordinator has consulted me. And hopefully, well-meaning Biafrans will look into that woman's matter. But this is not opening door for everybody to begin to call. Go and meet your coordinator. Because the next time you may call my platform to talk nonsense, you may not like it. But that woman will not be left alone. Look for IPOB family and join you. Because if that woman don't have a coordinator and not a recognized member of IPOB, she's not going anywhere. And so when you see people online telling you, we are Biafran Defense Force, let me tell you one truth. 42 people are missing in Aba for almost 3 years now. We can't give account of them because they refuse to listen. DSS actually took them, claiming on Facebook that they are Nigerian Defense, Biafran Defense Force. These people follow them on Facebook, thinking that they are our people. They are gone today. Those who know, know. We're not saying anything. DSS must know that we are aware of this plot, and those people, their death will never be in vain if they are dead, because we are still thinking about them. So you are a formidable Biafra. You are saying, give us all that. Give, look for IPOB family and then be born again. Be born again, my friend. Because our fathers fought to destroy a city, a nation, a country. Did I say a nation? A country built on falsehood, built on lie. Run for them. Run for them. They want to command you, but they don't want to be commanded. And then after, there was one saying he's Blue Jack. He's a professor. Go and meet Iruanya. When they introducing themselves, they said, yes, let us bring in professor. Then when professor finished talking, he said, let us bring his excellency. When his excellency finished, let us bring our Niger Delta brother. You think you are patronizing anybody? All the professors in Nigeria, what do they amount to? Without apology. What do they amount to? If you are a professor, you are, what do they call it? Intellectual, integritarian, corruption fighter. As a Biafran, I want you to go back and look at your oga on top. Of course, you understand. Your oga on top in office, watch it, is Ochenama. It's a cattle era. So when you are a Biafran, you are telling me you are intellectual. Intellectual being controlled by Ochenama, a cattle era. I think I have an issue there. I certainly lost regard and respect for you. And when they come, it's Blue Jack, Blue Jack, Blue Jack, hey, Blue Jack, hey, he's a formidable, he's a Niger Delta, he's going to give us Niger Delta, he will incorporate Niger Delta criminals, hey, they will support IPOB. If you never see road now, you no go see road again. Where is Blue Jack? No, where is Blue Jack? Hey, it's very formidable. Oh, it's a Tom Bomb Cosmos. It is a Bamba. They are very loyal. All of you supporting these lunatics, the criminal. Where are you today? You see? And now you know. Biafra is a spirit. And there are many of them still breeding. Breeding. Very formidable. We are media. We are very humble. Very gigantic. We are watching all of you. Including George Onyibe. All of us are suspect. All of us are suspect. Until you prove otherwise. But I'm going somewhere. And all of a sudden, there is another one. What do they call him? As I was listening to our radio, should it be USA or USA 1 or 2? I can't remember. And people were calling, what is the brother of this name? He first of all came and insulted IPOB. And Biafran's knowledgeable Biafran's attacked him. He made another video and he came back and said he apologized. What do they call this man's name, sir? Because I don't want to remember his name. He now apologized. And I listened to radio that day. Everybody was saying, yes, our brother has repented. Let us accept him. that our brother go and investigate. If they don't repent, they don't know what is coming for them. Hey, sad, you say you are sad, sit, you carry paper. But you are being paid by Iruanya. All of you need to consult me and you have yourself to clear. If you don't clear yourself, your disgrace will be bigger than that of Nebuchadnezzar. Hey, he said, our Niger Delta brother is formidable. You better look for IPOB family closer to you. Hey, our Igbo brothers are contributing money for me to leave North Iguawusa and return to Biafra land. But you can't speak your father's language. When you tell me you are Izo man, speak Izo. When you say you are Abo man, speak Abo. When you say you are Urobo man, speak Urobo. Stop deceiving yourself. One morning we don't pretend about it. Stop deceiving yourself. We know all of you. We are looking at all of you. The most miserable human beings, those who think they are fooling IPOB, you will see how hopeless you are. And you are there as a Biafran with your brain intact. You say, hey, this is our brother. He's formidable. You are sharing their video. Take record of people are mentioning. I have mentioned whether it's Okechukwu. I don't know his name. I have mentioned whether it's Green Jack. I don't know his name. I do not want to talk of Iruanya and his company because you know them already. I'm not talking about others. And now you have another one. Wait, what did they call it? When he can say, we are South and we are Southeast. He's painting mouth like Suleiman who want to deceive you to say Igbo presidency is the next president. And all of you are jumping up and down. This is what some of our fathers died for. To stop this country built on lies. Don't let it have influence over you. And then while we are trying to recover from that one, another one came out and said, I am Udo, I am Akwaibo, as I'm talking to you, I'm eating puff puff donut somewhere in America. And as I'm eating this puff puff, I'm Akwaibo, and I'm a Philippian brother. As I'm talking to you, I give IPOB 48 hours. Now they have re-indoctrinated him. Very soon, he will start singing for IPOB. And some of you will still bamboozle like a chimpanzee and follow him. Oh, is Udo, is he one of our Akwaibo brothers? Who told you? Don't you know the police commissioner in Abia State issuing us threat? Is Akwaibo, man. But who told you it's Akwaibo? Some of you, he's Udo now. Udo has repented. He's attacking Nigeria. All these people, what they need is a lot. They come to this platform. They call it favor. They look like human beings. They turn around and they stab you. Their sword is sharper than that of the blade of a fool. They stab you and leave you no room to survive. Beware of them. We know them. And now, I must call on my sister, who is always talking about Benin. But before I go there, we go to another brother. That brother say, about Benin is killing me. About Benin is pursuing me. About Benin, about Benin. Some of you are following him. Yeah, he's condemning about Benin. Who told you? All these people are paid agents. It's George Onyibe from Abo that is telling you. We have profiled them. We know where they are coming from. We know people behind them. We didn't come here to be spectators. We come here to be involved. I want you to watch all of them. They always come online when IPOB have major program. They have their strategy mapped out already. They come, they pretend to be one of you. They confuse you, a few of you, and they hit you. They've come to my inbox. This is how they do. They come there. Masi Onyibe, you are trying, you know, God will bless you. Elohim bless you. Chukwuka Kabiama bless you. You people are doing very well. Masi Onyibe, I know they are not helping you. They are not. But am I supposed to be help at my age? Am I supposed to become a liability to anybody at my expense of at my age? But they are going somewhere. They look for your weak spot and they come in. This thing Mazenan the Kanu is doing, don't you know that we have to unite, we have to come together? But is anybody actually saying we have not come together? And they say, how do you see this defense fund? They will subtly talk to you and you will be foolishly, you open your mouth for them. He say it's true, you know, Mazenan the Kanu, it's just that it's like this, is that they are documenting you. The moment they get you, they issue you a threat. And the moment they issue you this a threat, you must do their bidding. Unfailingly, you are in soup.
They were there, all of them campaigning. They kill, what is the name of this prophet? They kill this prophet Nwoko. Oh, is he dead? Now they can't kill him. Oh, Jaja Nibe kill him. Oh, Mazice Meva kill him. Oh, they beat up Bambo. All of you are following them. This is a nation built on lies. These are the agent of lies. I just want you to know them before we continue. I may have to preach like almost 3 hours. So prepare your ear. Buy cotton board. Get ready. They are mad people. Oh, hey, they kill Nwoko. Just 1 week of campaigning for Nwoko death, trying to blackmail IPOB. The next thing now, chapter have changed. Oh, hey, we want to bury Nwoko. Please, this is the account number 0901077690. Please bring money. Let's bury him. But when IPOB was paying his house rent, you didn't come to solicitate money to pay for his house rent. You see how wise you are. A nation built on fraud. This is what some of our heroes, living and dead, heroines, living and dead, fought to put an end to. And then there is my sister. She's not called my line. And I want you, maybe somewhere along the line, you need to come and clear yourself. Because if you are following all these criminals, they are deceiving you. Benin is a Biafra. Ibaki is a Biafra. Hausa is Biafra. In fact, Atiku is a Biafra. But we know our people. We know ourselves.
Amaramu nyengwim. Don't think you are deceiving us.
Hey, about Bini do this? Hey, Bini, we are Biafra. Oh, we are Biafra, Biafra. Biafra.
If you are part of the people calling Mazen Nandekano, Mazen Nandekalo, go and adjust your teeth and reposition your tongue. Because that is an evil old man. His name is not Carlo. His name is Kano. You are just like the people who are saying, hey, we are Biafra, Biafra. Because Chukwu Okikabiamo will not allow you to be able to pronounce Biafra. This is the name of the spirit.
Biafra, we are Biafra. Our side is Biafra. Very soon now, Yoruba will be Biafra. Everybody Biafra. These are paid agents. They are working underground. But we are monitoring them. That leg where they waka chon chon chon. He get eye where they see chon chon chon. We are watching all of you. So be 30th of May is here. Come out and tell us you own Nigeria.
You will understand how hopeless you will be in the end of it. I saw our volunteers. They were doing rally across everywhere. And I ran into them along the line. And I tried to video them. They blocked the road. And there was no, in fact, their crowd actually caused a little bit of hold up. And I entered the next taxi going to my location. And the two men sitting behind me, maybe they listen to Radio Biafra. They'll be hearing me. They now start saying, now here they won't do for Biafra. If they won't do for Biafra, make them go Abuja, go do Biafra. Make them know the suburb. See, as they don't block road now, then they just they talk. My mind they boil.
I say, Lord, lead me not into temptation, but deliver me from all evil. For thou, oh my God, my body they panic like this. Their mouth just they run. No wonder my leader said that men have become gossipers. Why don't they go to Abuja? Why will you go to Abuja? When necessary, we go to Abuja. Are we Abuja people? When necessary, we will protest in Yoruba land. Are we Yoruba people? Can Yoruba protest in Biafra land? Can Hausa protest in Biafra? Don't you have sense? They yap. I was just praying, oh Lord my God, oh Lord my God, deliver me from temptation.
Because maybe, I don't know the message you have heard, you would have heard this evening.
But these are supposed to be wise men.
And God helped me. From the beginning of the journey to the end, I didn't make him because I was waiting for them to say, bros, how you see I'm now? Make I cure their disease. But they didn't come to me. You know, I have to respect myself. They say respect is reciprocal. I was waiting for them to say, hey, bros, how you see the matter now? Only God knows where they would have been now. They would have still been heartbroken. What am I trying to say in effect? Nigeria is a country built by lies. And then when we are seeing people say, Biafra, 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 If FA is not using her head, FA, we are looking at you. If you are not using your head, you know what I'm saying is true. FA, know how many people that have contacted her. Hey, they come and... But let me not go there. But all of you stand your ground. This is an empire of lie. Criminals. No, go back and look at Jubri online.
I want to first of all thank my teacher. My teacher taught me well when I was in Otakara. I was in boarding school.
Your president of Nigeria, who don't have a WAEC, a school certificate, went to boarding school in Otakara.
You know what is Otakara? I didn't say primary school. Did you not hear him?
A niche, a country built on lies. They lie more than Satan. Information minister, liar Muhammad. I told you, in heaven, it's going to be mysterious. Heaven is going to be confusion. Because Satan will win in the end. You know why? Because many pastors, many imam, many farm, many politicians, many, they lie more than Satan. Information minister, liar Muhammad. If he lie, Satan mind go fly.
Now Satan will be vindicated at the end of the day. That is why I see some boys on Facebook with say we serve Ekwensu, we are children of Ekwensu. I don't blame them.
Because when information minister of Nigeria has developed the capacity of lying more than Satan, why will I blame Satan?
Now you must know why they died, to stop a country like this. Now let's look at the three nations that make up the country called Nigeria. Let's start from Oduduwa Nation. All of a sudden, one of the terrorists raised alarm, but it's a false alarm. Because Obasanjo and his generation and his people will never be free from the heinous crime they committed against our people. But now, the prophecy is coming true. The man who saw tomorrow, Mazen Nanekan, everything he's saying is manifesting. Now, let me tell you, don't wait for further prophecy. We are waiting for all of you to identify. Show yourself. So we enter the next stage.
Oh, they want to fulanize Nigeria. Oh, hey, they want to fulanize Nigeria. Oh, hey, I am Obasanjo. I'm a founding father. Oh, I'm one of the rapists of Nigerian founder. Oh, hey, I didn't go to school. I'm illiterate. Oh, but British government want me to be a founding father. Oh, come, oh, before they fulanize us. Oh.
But has Yoruba not been fulanized already?
And then the next morning, another one say, oh, I'm Wolosho Inka, oh, I'm a very courteous man, oh, I'm the one who actually formed courteous, oh, the money they gave to me to start road safety, I stole it, oh, hey, wait, come and help us, oh, they are fulanizing us, oh. And now the next day, some people say, oh, we are Robo elders, oh, and we are Shekiri elders, oh, we are Niger Delta elders, oh, hey, we are Hanes Ndibo, we support what Yoruba say, oh, don't let them fulanize us, oh, they are colluding, oh, we are Tiwa Danjuma, oh.
But remaining one voice. Remaining one voice. Jack Gowan.
He must make this confession. He keep quiet, they will kill his people.
He must make this confession. This is just the beginning.
They have rallied round. The Yoruba, Oduduwa Nation have rallied round. Let's see if we can be able to look at what they are trying to make you see. The Yoruba extraction. This is some of the things they do. Let's follow it a little bit. The warning from the people. Like former President Olusegun Obasanjo, former Chief of Army Staff, retired General Tiwa Danjuma, and host of others about Buhari's Islamization and Fulanization agenda is a little too late, I'm afraid.
This is a statement issued by Oduduwa Extraction of Terrorists.
Very lazy people. Those warning are as useless as a man warning his household about a supposed impending fire outbreak after the fire has already gotten their house. Fact is, Buhari is currently not implementing any ecuoc religion agenda. He has since finished the implementation and now consolidation on it. And in fairness to him, he has never hidden the fact that he is an incredible ecuoc religion hegemonist. The only piece of information that will save Nigeria, especially Southerners and non-Fulani Northerns now, is to neutralize
the Islamization and Fulanization, or at least survive them because they are here already. But Mazen Adekano said this in 2014-2015.
All of you say it's hate speech. How can it be hate speech?
But you have not seen hate speech anyway. When a president of a multi-ethnic, multi-religion and multicultural country like Nigeria is busy filling all his appointments with only people from his own region and religion, handing over the entire security agents, including the military, to only one people from his own region and religion, protecting Islamist terrorists from his own region and religion, while sending Python dance and armor tank and soldiers after unarmed peaceful agitators from other regions, but they are afraid to mention IPOB. Do you need someone to tell you that such a president is implementing an ethnic religion agenda, especially when that president is one who has presided over the country in the past, where he showed worst of his ethnic religion bigot by throwing the vice president of the government he overthrown, later Dr. Alex Ekweme, an Igbo Christian, into Kirikiri, maximum security prison, while leaving the main president, Alhaji Shehu Shagari, a Fulani Muslim like himself, in a comfortable apartment in the name of house arrest. I think the problem is most of us imagine Islamic Jihad to be some group of badly dressed desert dwellers riding on horseback while chanting convert to Islam or Bikalidi, whatever it is. The same way we imagine Islamization to mean a situation where everyone will be forced to start praying towards Mecca. The world has changed, and so has everyone along with it. No one need to force you to start going to mosque before you realize you have become Islamized. Let's stop there. Now, if you look at what these people are seeing, they're making sense, honestly. But this sense they are making is not for you. It's not for you, Biafran. All of a sudden, they now begin to remember Alex Ekweme. But why are they not be remembering Alex Ekweme? Does even Alex Ekweme remember himself? Alex Ekweme was the vice president of Nigeria under the first democratic elected president of Nigeria, Olusegun Obasanjo. He was overthrown by the terrorist made Buhari, who now threw Alex Ekweme into prison. Ambrose Ali, among others, most of them died there. Ambrose Ali came out blind. Alex Ekweme cried, they lied against me, blatant lied. But did he not die as a Nigerian? Now I am shouting, Nigeria is a country of blatant lie. But I'm not Alex Ekweme. How will you accept the truth? The same man now, who you are not ashamed because you are made up of lie. Oh, is he corruption fighter? Is he? But how are they fighting this corruption? Is he looting part of corruption python? Because maybe that is the department I'm going to work very soon. So when Yoruba is saying it, oh, Yoruba mean us well. It's a lie. Oh. A nation built on falsehood. They built on lie. When they tell you good morning in Nigeria, please check your time. Any proud Nigerian tells you good morning is in your country, please check your time. It's not their fault. If your executives, your legislature, your judiciary are all headed by people from a particular region and religion, if your security agents, indeed all institutions of the state, were shown and virtually in the hand of only people from a particular region and religion, if your own lawmaker, politician, leaders who are Christians and Southerners, all who have bowed their knee, dressed like those of other people who saw the Femi Banjibi Milai and Ibe Kachuku recently. Yes, I know they were coming to Ibe Kachuku. Ibe Kachuku was one of Biafran jumping up and down. Yeah, but Ali must give us account of NNPC. How dare he become Jubri? And you know what they give us account? I will go to Aso Rock and I'll find for myself. Ibe Kachuku went to Aso Rock to see Jubri. While he was seeing Jubri, his house was burned down in Abuja. And before he got home, his house was burned down. And he had to lodge in a hotel for some days.
Maybe they made a phone call to him and say, you give fresh statement, you are dead. We hear you make pain, you are finished. Now look at him now. He's doing Allah kubara la la hilala bakara misi hilala. Look at him, Bekachuku. Naija Delta, my foot. Nigeria, my foot. Only the sovereign nation will survive. But the Yoruba know how to pen their, they know how to wield their, the sword of their pen very well. Before they get, they can get a position they are qualified for. If a governor in an exclusive Christian state like Enugu had to start his inauguration for second term with a Jamaat service in a mosque, just because he need to pander to some interest, a few that is reading this have had cause to contemplate changing your name to sound like that of those people of Alamajiri, because you know an Islamic or Fulani sounding name will give you a job in NNPC, in Central Bank of the Zoo, while a Christian Southern sound name disqualify you from the same job. If a clubhouse in capital city could be demolished for non-just cause, if Muslim youth could attack a Catholic church in Suleja, Niger, simply for worshipping on Friday with the police not prosecuting any of them, if a female pastor with Redeemed Christian Church, Eunice Elisha, could be beheaded right here in Abuja simply for preaching in a street housing a mosque, with the police releasing all the Muslim youth arrested without charge, a Fulani herdsman could rape, maim, and carry out ethnic cleansing with government sponsoring impunity, etc. If all of most of these conditions applies, you are already Islamized and Fulanized. If you don't yet realize it, you soon will. Buhari did not spend 12 years, solid years, contesting to be president just to become and grow the economic, build road, provide infrastructure and electricity, not at all. He spent all these years, carried all those tears, even went to church, thanked and allowed Islam, just he could get the chance to carry out what his ancestors, Usman and Fudu, started in 1804. Everything Buhari is doing today was planned many years ago. Today, the entire country is firmly in the hand of Fulani ethnic terrorists. If you are a Fulani or a Muslim, you can kill and maim soldiers and civilians alike, and nothing will happen. I hope you are there. Now, what Yoruba saying? I'm showing you how a nation built on falsehood is. Yoruba are trying to create attention. And Biafrans are going to support Yoruba and say, this thing is true. Yes, it's true. We are believing it. It's true. Just to draw you to their side to fight Hausa. Don't be stupid. Don't join Yoruba. Let Yoruba do their fight. Of course, their beat is catching Niger Delta. They are telling you now that Niger Delta, some Niger Delta elders have supported Yoruba. Woo! Woo! Shame on all of you. A country built online. Yoruba, 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 who do the one nation for your own interest. You are hallucinating. Then you come to the other extraction of Nigerians. The Arewa nation. Watch Arewa man. They lie with impunity. The Arewa nation, they lie with impunity. They can wake up in the morning and tell you that the rain that fell was dropping fire. Even when they know that it's like almost impossible for rain to drop fire. But of course, you have been compromised. You will believe. You have been compromised. So the only thing I would say about them is that they lie with impunity. Yeah, we the Arewa, we giving Igbo quick notice because Igbo have destroyed our land. Igbo are mechanizing and looting money. Igbos are. They lie with impunity. Lie more than devil. That is their lot. That is their way. A nation built on falsehood. And then you come to the Biafrans. Majority, as a result of fear,
are trying to sound politically correct, having been compromised. Now, let's go back to Arewa. When Arewa lie with impunity, you must have one thing at the back of your mind. They do this because they know they have the backing of Islamic nation around the world. They know they have the backing of United Nations. Fulani terrorists, jihadists know they have the backing of British government. That is why they lie with impunity without apology. Of course, when you come to the Biafran extraction, majority as a result of fear are trying to sound politically correct, all because they've been compromised. They've been compromised. You see, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu doesn't have the way to give Biafra. Then who has? IPOB should have consulted United Nations. Then why don't you go ahead of us? I think we should have approached, engaged the world in so this. And then why don't you do it for us? That is how they call your kind in my language. But what, how will you understand? But we know your kind. Nigeria is built on falsehood. Your envy and jealousy will only kill you. Our supreme leader remains Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. And the only voice that speaks for us remains Radio Biafra. And IPOB is the only entity we know in Biafra. Very soon, your envy and jealousy will kill you. But we don't blame you. Nigeria is a country built on falsehood. These are some of the reasons why our ancestors, our fathers and mothers, they put their life on the line. They put their life on the line just for us to be alive. And I see that the sacrifice will never be in vain. The sacrifice of our heroes, it will never be in vain. These are some of the reasons they choose to die, to stop lies. Lies like Igbo presidency, Second Niger Bridge, Ogoni clean up, One United, One Nigeria. They lie. The highest of it all. Nigeria is the only country in the world where they want to put one to project force unity. Oh, this is our one Nigeria. It can never be territorial integrity or interpreted. We are one indivisible and united Nigerian entity. The integratorial terror. The point is that even British government helped them to lie. David Cameron, Theresa May, and others. The territorial integrity of the territorial. You are what a nation built on falsehood. Have it at the back of your mind. 30th of May, we remember our fallen hero and heroine. And their sacrifice, we say, should never, will never be in vain. I'll be back in a minute.
Yes, sir. Hey, Biafra, we are wasting much of our time. Our lines are open at this moment. Our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. Our WhatsApp line, once again, is 070-815-45642. For the last time, our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. Our direct line is 081-221-52971. Our direct line, once again, is 081-221-52971. 081-221-52971. Our direct line. And then the special line for the female is 081-288-58614. Special number for the female is 081-288-58614. And of course, at this moment, our lines are open. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from?
My name is Mazichima Joseph Onyechukwu. I'm calling from Sukasari, the Carmona.
Go ahead, please.
Yes, Meshuko Karim, I keep on strengthening you and bless all Biafrans. And I want to use this opportunity to show the world that what we have been saying for long is now in our foot. And that's our target name. The day that we remember those people who fight, who died, not because they want to die, but on their way, when they are fighting for us, when they are fighting so that this land will be okay. And along the line, they met their death. So we, the Enugu people, we are ever resolute. Today, we show the zoo called Nigeria that Enugu state belongs to Biafra land. We protest in Ogo Etemama market. Every place was shut down. And we learn the word. And even tomorrow, we keep on doing it until we reach our destination. Our destination is Biafra, and nothing can stop us. There's no any amount of intimidation. There's no any amount of arrest. There's no anything that the zoo called Nigeria can do for us to can stop us. Because we are out on this thing, and we must get our freedom. And I say, Mr. Okama, keep on threatening our people as we all are doing our target name. As we are observing it, There are the only soul that said that he's not going to observe it. Mechuko Kalema track that person down and his entire generation down. Unless because if he's, what, if at all you believe on this struggle, Mechuko Kalema bless you. Mechuko Kalema's name I pray. Wuro kena na asa onde ba inde luku ana me klesu unike obi shu unike makani unu anom ni hunu merenta but the 28th day of May 2019 ya water that ne luku seta ke luku seta gan already owo die na fundu su wori ki mayin ma jo yin be iwo ache agene di zu police onde no na agene holy ghost round about you want the hand church agba petet me moto na agbo so bu mu chineke na bia you want that you have get the afra we have got what you are looking for. And nothing can change it. Obi say okay, on this next tomorrow, Abemagu one day, Abemagu weeks, no, on my next tomorrow. By the meditation to me, Umbosamo, Abombosi, Maya Jemu Alamoai, Umbosai, I wrote 200 decisions. Rather, it's a day that you show the world that you are ever resolute. It's a day that you remember those people who died so that we can have a good thing. My son, I say, remember resolute and make sure my people to rescue every one of us.
Thank you very much. We must continue calling on the line. Your name and where are you calling from? Call on the line. A contribute on falsehood. Oh, they are rebellion. They are rebellion. You have a mind. You gather millions of children. You starve them to death. Today you come out to justify yourself to tell us to leave it for God. You lie. The sacrifice of these people will never be in vain. You lie. Look at little children. You are calling them that, oh, they are rebellion. They are rebel. They are rebel. You are man of God. You are the man of God. Call on the line, your name, and where are you calling from?
Hello, my good evening, sir.
Good evening from here. Go ahead, please.
My name is Miss Chema. I'm calling from Aba. I'm from Ibira. Now, I want to thank you this night. At least God has strengthened you today to reach the end of this hour, particularly because it has almost reached. And I want to use this opportunity to warn parents and guidance that have their children and their wards in Santana. That is a school called Santana. Santana International School. It's in Tracker Road by White School. I passed there today when I was coming back from school. And I had their teachers. They were discussing that they have school on Thursday. They were telling one of their students that she should remember to come to school on Thursday, that tomorrow is public holiday, but a Thursday is school. And I asked the woman, how can Thursday be school? Are you people not hearing this at all?